I'm Ming Tian. I'm a professor in the Department of Biochemistry and Molecular Biology at Penn State University. I've been here 23 years working on the so-called lignin problem. Lignin is what nature evolved as an adaptation to life on dry land. Even though lignin serves nature well in giving plants structural rigidity, it is a problem as far as trying to gain access to the carbohydrates in plant material to convert that carbohydrate to ethanol. What we did is we took a gene from the common little pea and put that gene into poplar, and that what this gene does is make a protein now that can be inserted into the lignin polymer. So now we have a protein stuck in there, and it's much easier to degrade the protein than it is to degrade lignin.
Here we have many transgenic plants that are expressing this novel cell wall protein. This is a wild type hybrid that has not been transformed, and as you can see, the transgenic hybrids, the biotechnology modified hybrid that is expressing large amounts of the cell wall protein, looks identical to the normal wild type hybrid poplar. And that is our goal in this process, to improve the extractability of carbohydrates from the poplar stems without affecting the form of the hybrids, their growth rates, or their ability to withstand disease and insect infestation.
Pretreatment, or getting around the lignin barrier, is the most expensive part of this whole process. So any avenues, any methods where we can make this process cheaper will eventually make biofuels something that's economically competitive and, of course, benefit the consumer.